I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Coming up on UPC, would you be interested in making $8.50 an hour for the holidays?
A romp by the Lady Cougars soccer team coming up today in sports.
Marine Biology Club, your calendars are in and we know where to get them. All this and more is coming up on UPC and it starts right now.
Welcome to the Tuesday, December 7th edition of the UPC Morning Show. I'm Andrea Larson.
And I'm Jennifer Conti. There will be a Christians in Action meeting this Thursday, the 9th, in room B7 at 205. Go and join the fun. Attention PTSA student ambassadors. There will be a luncheon meeting from 11:15 to 12:55 on Thursday, December 9th in the mediation room, F7. Lunch is included. Yearbook photos will be taken at that time, so please plan to attend.
Do you know about the new computer lab? Well, here's Jen with the scoop.
In the past year, Countryside has gained much more technology. One of the most upcoming pieces of technology is the new computer labs.
I just bought my new computer, and it's the same thing, and I like it because I can go home, and at home and school is the same computer, so I'm used to it, and it's very nice, and they're cool. They look cool. Do you see how cool? Look how cool they look. These computers. Don't they look cool? Don't they look cool?
A computer lab is a classroom for teaching computer skills.
Although we already have these computers, the new computer lab will offer more advanced technology.
Well, there'll be 30 brand new IBM computers and a classroom environment right here in the library. We're currently moving books around so that we can accommodate it. It'll be set up so that we can teach research skills, computer skills, and different things with computers.
I'm very excited that we're getting new technology here. I think it's about time. I'm glad that this technology is going to be here so I can advance my education. I just can't wait. I'm just really excited.
The new computer labs will help further the learning here at Countryside High School. For more information, see any of the two librarians. Jennifer Conti, UPC.
Thanks, Jen. Attention Art Club members, please remember to pick up your ornaments before or after school. There will be a brief sophomore meeting on Thursday, December 9th in Miss Garrett's room. They will be taking the sophomore class picture. All who are active in the sophomore class, please attend. If you have any questions, please see Nicole Bungeport. The deadline for entering the PTSA Reflections Program is approaching fast. Entries will be collected on Wednesday and Friday of this week. A collection box will be set up in Ms. Huzzer's office during the week. The final deadline is Friday, December 10th at 1 o'clock. Now here's Alfredo with sports.
Thanks a lot, girls. I'm Alfredo Muente with UPC Sports. Friday night, the girls' soccer team defeated Northeast barely. No, just kidding. 10-0 was the final score. They dropped them like a bad habit, did they? They improved their record to 4-1-1. Scoring two goals each were Keely Latham and Jessica Engelman. Also scoring a goal were Melissa Burley, Ashley Law, Julie Artino, Lauren Jackson, Carrie Smetzer, and Amanda Dick. Great job to all the girls. Also, good luck to the Lady Cougar basketball team, who will take on the Eastlake Eagles tonight on the road. And same to the boys soccer team, who will host Tarpon Springs here at Cougar Field tonight at 6. And tomorrow night, the wrestling team will be in action, and they will be on the road taking on the Clearwater Tornadoes in a district match. Good luck to the wrestling squad. All right, yesterday at Raymond James Stadium in Tampa was the Monday Night Football. For the second time this year, the Buccaneers competing against their NFC Central rival, the Minnesota Vikings. The final score, the Bucs comes up with their victory 24-17 to improve their record to 8-4. Tampa Bay on a current five-game winning streak. Sean King, the starter for the first time in his career, the graduate out of Gibbs High School in St. Petersburg, went 11-19, threw 93 yards, an interception, and two touchdowns. Next week, Tampa Bay with a major showdown against the Detroit Lions for first place in the NFC Central. And that should be an exciting matchup. Yesterday in overtime out on the West Coast, it was the Tampa Bay Lightning with a 3-3 tie against the San Jose Sharks, wrapping up 1 point in the NHL Eastern Conference standings. Scoring goals for Tampa Bay: Darcy Tucker, his sixth of the season, Mike Sillinger with his seventh, and also Robert Petrovicki, he scored his fourth. And yesterday, the Downtown Athletic Club named its candidates for the Heisman Trophy winner. And this year, the candidates will be Wisconsin running back Ron Dayne, quarterbacks Joey Hamilton out of Georgia Tech, Marshall quarterback Chad Pennington, Michael Vick, the freshman quarterback out of Virginia Tech, and Purdue's quarterback Drew Brees. And that'll wrap it up today in sports. Now back to you guys.
Thanks, Alfredo. The Marine Biology Club officers, there will be a brief meeting today in F5. See the UPS representative today for an $8.50 an hour holiday job. Meet the representative at 1:50 today in front of the media center.
There will be a CROP meeting tomorrow during second period. Members should ask their second period teachers for the CROP passes to attend. Students with passes will meet in the auditorium upstairs. Marine Biology Club members can pick up their December calendars for this month's schedules in F5 or from your biology teacher.
Okay, now we have one last minute announcement.
Happy 18th birthday to Christy Sinclair. Love all your friends and James.
That's it.
Bye.